Hey there guys, this is Bassinger 313 here with a video of the Palutena's Guidance. Now what it is basically a codex from Super Smash Bros. Brawl with Snake. And basically, it's just every single character has these codec moments, and I am looking forward to seeing what they have to offer. I really need to do a reaction video just takes codec as well if I ever get a copy of Brawl. So basically, yeah, every single character has these codec things, and to do that you just spam the down taunt from Tits. And we're gonna start right now, if it ever contacts, whatever. This may take a while. There we go. I have not played Kid Icarus Optimizing, by the way, so I might not be the majority to actually know much of these, but
you know who this guy is, don't you, Pit?
Of course I do! It's Mario!
He was your first ally in the fight against the subspace army.
Oh, I like how they made that reference.
He's actually quite famous. There aren't many people who don't know who Mario is.
Come, yeah.
I don't know whether to fight him or ask for his autograph.
Fight first, fanboy later.
Do you think he'll sign my wings?
Oh my god. Oh my god, Pit, you're pathetic. So, okay, I'm really finding these things amusing right now, so... And I'm going through every single character, including all the unlockables that I just had to recently unlock. I also don't like the controls. Hold on a minute. Good thing I made two separate controls for this. This one's player one, okay. Alright, next up is Luigi. Let's do this. I want to know, can you do it the Omega form though? I'm testing this out to see if you could do the Omega form. It might not work, but... might as well check. Alright. I don't know the specifics as to how you do this. All I did was mash the down button on the D-pad and then it eventually works. I don't know how long it takes, it seems like it's completely random. But as if you keep on spamming it, then it'll eventually work. And I know that if you interrupt Pit while he's fighting, then that disrupts the codec thing and then it'll never happen again until the next match. So it doesn't look like it works on the Omega stages, so... we'll do this again, this time with not the Omega stage. Oh man, I could already... see the insults for Luigi. Poor Luigi. I don't know, like, if it's gonna be anything like the codex in Smash Bros. Brawl, someone's gonna make fun of Luigi, I just know it. I don't know if it's gonna be Palutena or Pit or whatever. I hate how they spawn you guys, like, completely far away from each other, like. I really like this music, by the way. There we go.
Look! It's Luigi!
Always a bridesmaid, never a bride.
What?
Oh, don't say that. After all, he even had his own year.
I don't remember that. Though I suppose if he's number two out of all these fighters, actually pretty good.
His attacks are no joke.
You're right. Have you seen his super jump punch and green missile? In some ways, he might even be stronger than his brother.
Oh shit.
Oops. Bad about that unfortunate L on his forehead.
Oh god.
Sure, stands for winner.
Oh, you dude, that bitch is cold. Does he have like a grudge against Luigi or some shit? Because that is just... I mean, I knew coming into this that there was a possibility that Luigi's gonna be make fun of because he's always like the overshadowed brother ever since pretty much the first game. So I should disable that final smash. I was playing a little bit earlier. As you can tell why that final smash is there. Just this real quickly. Okay, there we go. That way we won't get interrupted by any crowd noises or whatever. Next up is the princess who keeps getting fucking kidnapped! Oh my god, alright. Jesus, fuck, why do they like spawn so far away? Okay. Oh, oops. Yeah, it's... always a lot tedious when this happens. Like with Snake, you just spam. I think. Hold on. Let me just spam the D-pad. No, it seems to have like the same results.
Oh, it's Princess Peach!
Guess she's taking a break from being kidnapped.
I'm so glad we never have to worry about Lady Palutena. She can take care of herself.
Really?
Can't she?
Wasn't she imprisoned by Medusa for a bit there?
That hardly counts. After all, we were just freshmen back then. That would never happen now that we're more experienced.
Peach has been in plenty of scrapes herself, so she ought to be quite experienced. And yet, she never learns. Sometimes I wonder if she just lets herself get kidnapped for fun.
I don't know about that. It seems like tossing vegetables is more her idea of fun. She'll pelt you with them the whole match if you don't watch it. But she can't reload when she's jumping, so keep your eye on what she's up to.
Alright. So even the game acknowledges why she keeps on getting kidnapped and such. It's like, bitch, stop getting kidnapped. You could kick some ass, then why don't you actually kick some ass? Unless you're actually enjoying getting kidnapped and such. Wonder where the kids came from. Oh, fuck. It's very hard trying to... Oh, goddamn. It's kind of hard controlling two controllers at the same time. I don't have a friend with me, so it's not like we could co-commentate together and... Oh, fuck! I forgot! No Omega Stages. Why the hell did I do that?
Three, two, one,
Oh, if only there was like a button instead of just doing LRA start to just get out of the match, because
no contest.
I don't know, I kind of find that annoying, especially since I recently played the 3DS version, and all I had to do is just pause and then there's a quit button, that's it. Maybe it's on the Wii U gamepad, who knows. I'll check after this codec to see if it's on the Wii U gamepad.
Three, two, one, go!
Alright. I'm not sure we really need to be close to each other to do this. Wow, that was fast! Why can't it be more like that, game?
When I think of Bowser, I always picture him deep in his castle steeling himself for a fight.
Or, you know, playing golf or racing a go-kart.
Who is this chick anyways?
He's looking pretty aggro today. Must be because he's in a fighting game.
BAM! Confirm! Smash Bros, a fighting game, bitch!
It all sounds like something from an 8-bit action movie.
That, I won't lie. I'm a little scared.
Don't be. Bowser may be powerful, but he also leaves big openings. Fight smart and look for chances to counterattack.
So confirmed by the man himself, ladies and gentlemen, Super Smash Bros. Is in fact a fighting game. There's your proof.
No
motherfuckers.
Contest.
That's my new argument. Just go to the Bowser's code deck in Super Smash Bros. For Wii U as your confirmation whether or not it's a fighting game or not. It is. If it really wasn't, then Sakurai would have just removed that all entirely. So, fuck you guys for saying it's not a fighting game. Because it is most simply, in fact, it is.
Alright.
It's down on the D-pad, right? Yeah, it's down on the D-pad. I hate how sometimes it's just completely random, like, it's pretty much luck if you get the codec or not. I mean, you get it eventually, but it's still annoying when it's
Yoshi!
Not gonna...
Let
Yummy!
Me get this straight. Yoshi lays eggs, but he's actually male?
Yeah, you got a problem.
Shouldn't you know that, oh goddess of nature?
There's nothing natural about this guy.
Yeah.
What?
I see your point.
Well, all living beings...
Goddess of nature, you created her!
Elements. It
I mean, unless...
She is no different.
I don't know.
What's
nature creates
eggs.
Animals Chocolate? And plants and such, right?
Focus
what?
Pit. If you use your shield
chocolate?
And Yoshi's pulling off an egg roll, you can grab him. Keep that in mind.
Does that taste like chocolate pit? Just saying. Does that taste like chocolate? Alright. Next! Yes, I'm using Classic Controller and the Pro Controller. Suck on it, GameCube players. Alright.
No contest.
I do have a GameCube adapter, by the way. Hold on. Check this out. If the loading screen ever starts.
Survival.
Bam. So I do have a GameCube adapter, I just choose not to do it. The only reason why I have a GameCube adapter is because a lot of my friends normally play on a GameCube controller and they say they fucking hate playing this game on a classic controller, so you know what? As the perfectly good friend I am willing to buy the GameCube controller just to play with my friends because they're all bitches. Alright, Rosalina Luma. I don't know what to say about this one. Maybe there could be like a goddess fight between Rosalina and Palutena. I want to know why it's only Pit that's getting the code deck and not Palutena or even Dark Pit.
And here we have Rosalina.
Yes.
She already sounds bitter.
The Comet Observatory and Mother of the Lumas.
Why is that comfy pillow following her? I love pillows.
That is a Luma, and this is no pillow fight.
You want to see how this pillow hits? Bam! You think that's a pillow now?
Rosalina seems kind of rough with the little guy.
There are plenty of Lumas, so losing a few isn't a big deal.
Oh, what?
Not a big deal?
Yo, that's like
sacrifice everything to protect Rosalina.
Yo, that's like their children though.
Much, but they're powerful enough.
It's like throwing a baby as a weapon. What the hell? Dude, now I'm kind of thinking about it. Rosalina, you're kind of a bitch, you know that? You're willing to throw your own children like that to die for you in battle? I mean, with the Pikmin, it's... Even so, with the Pikmin, it's kind of... Olimar and Princess Luma. I mean, Princess Rosalina. She's not a princess, never mind. They're fucking animal cruelty up the bit. Holy shit. Nintendo, what's wrong with you? No wonder why PETA's going after your asses. I'm liking the junior part of the junior. Alright.
Three, two, one, go!
This place kind of reminds me of Fire Emblem. And Skyward from Legend of Zelda.
Is that Bowser Jr.?
Yes! He is the heir to the Koopa throne.
So yeah, who is this girl?
I wonder if his father bought him that junior clown car. It's decked out with all sorts of bells and whistles.
Hey, I just thought of an even better name for it. How about the Shellicopter?
Needless to say, the junior
Kid, you're a
clown
dork, you know
car
that.
Is one tricky vehicle.
It's immune to many attacks, so strike when Bowser Jr. is exposed.
So what you're saying is to hit him from above, right?
Okay. Yeah, Pit, you're kind of a dork. Now that I actually realize this.
No contest.
I mean, I kind of thought Pit was like a generic anime character before, but now he really is a generic anime character. Next up, we got...
Mario.
Bad Mario. The wa means bad in Japanese, if you guys didn't know. Thank God I'm taking Japanese classes. That way I could actually understand more about Japanese culture, I guess. And I'm still gonna make fun of it. Alright. Wow, did Mario get like a... That's a really weird... walk, Mario. Waka 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 waka. Waka 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 waka. God damn it, Pit! Hurry up with your fucking codec! There we go. How's this gonna turn out?
Wario kind of smells.
That's to be expected. For his final smash, he munches nasty garlic and transforms into his super anti-hero alter ego, Wario Man.
Oh, that doesn't damage him?
Wario Man?
Yes. Legend has it that Wario once caught a cold, accidentally ate a piece of nasty garlic, and turned into Wario Man.
Huh. So nasty garlic is the key to Wario's power. Great.
He's a real charmer, that one.
Speaking of which, eating seems to make Wario very gassy.
Oh, TMI?
I'm only telling you this for your own good. He's a ticking time bomb. Watch out for his sudden farts. And all farts in general. They're gross and dangerous.
This job is really the worst sometimes.
I like Palutena's pose as if she's kind of like... I don't know, like, that pose just looks really funny to me. Yeah, they kind of feel very similar to the codex, except in Snake's case, it's only two characters. This one, they show, like, 2 to 3 characters and such. I still don't know who that girl is. They haven't... to newcomer Kid Icarus fans, or want to be getting into Kid Icarus, I really want to know what her name was. Who was the goddess of nature? That's what I want to know. That would give me an idea. I have not really studied up on my Greek mythology or anything, so... Hell, I don't even know what the fuck goddess Palutena is. Alright, is this Dark Bits theme? Alright.
Looks like it's me versus DK.
His arms are like tree trunks, so his attacks are incredibly powerful. Given his size, he also moves quite quickly. Combine that speed and power with his long reach, and you've got an opponent who's good at almost everything.
Yeah, except for dressing himself. That necktie what? Really doesn't leave much to the imagination.
True, but it is his signature look. It's probably best not to mention it.
Yeah, you wouldn't want to be on the receiving end of one of his giant punches or smash attacks. When he attacks you, don't use your shield. Just get out of the way, and then counterattack.
And watch where you come in for a landing.
Shielding is fine, though. Like, doesn't seem like it takes too much shield power away, but... At the same time, it's a lot more than other attacks, I guess, so... It takes, like, 3 regular punches. Maybe I have to power up my punches in order to fully break it or something, so... I think that's what Donkey Kong's more about, is like shield breaking, and if you fucking not shielded while he's punching you, then you're fucked. Alright, Diddy Kong! I wanna know why Diddy Kong wears clothes. Donkey Kong always just wears a tie and he's completely naked, basically. Diddy Kong, on the other hand, he at least wears a fucking shirt. Still pantsless, nonetheless, but... I mean, at least it's better than... Is Donkey Kong Diddy Kong's father or something? Or brother? Or like, what's their relationship to each other? What the hell did you do, Diddy Kong? You were like... doing something, I don't even know.
Oh, look! It's Diddy Kong!
He's Donkey Kong's little buddy.
Little buddy,
wonder if he'd
okay.
let me win for a banana.
Don't underestimate him just because he's a monkey. He's faster and stronger than any human.
As long as he can't fly, I'm good.
He can't fly, but he does have a peanut pop gun and an inexhaustible supply of peanuts to shoot at you.
So? I love peanuts!
Not when they're pelting you in the face.
I don't know. Still sounds pretty good to me.
Oh, Pigs! What won't you do for a snack?
Fighting does take
Wasn't
strength.
There like an anime
anyway,
show where,
Kong,
or an anime
right
episode
angle,
of Kid Icarus?
However, it explodes when it lands on the ground, so watch out.
Isn't there like an anime thingamabobber on YouTube where like Palutena was trying to fight against vegetables or something? From what I remember. I remember really liking that episode. It was fucked up and weird, but funny nonetheless. They really need to make some sort of Nintendo anime show, like fucking hell, Nintendo, please take my money. I'm willing to fucking fund that thing, alright? Oh, it's wrong character. Alright, the 2-bit man him or yeah, 2-bit, isn't it? What would you classify a Game & Watch series like? If the NES is 8-bit, then what the hell is like Mr. Game & Watch 2-bit? I mean, the Atari would be 4-bit, I guess. So what's before Atari is Game & Watch? I don't know. All right. I'm really liking his new like animation. They actually had to take the time to animate Mr. Game & Watch. Like,
hey, it's a shadow bug.
A
no,
what?
That's just Mr. Game & Watch.
Watch out for number 9, Pit!
What are you talking about?
Mr. Game & Watch's judge attack displays random numbers. And when
oh, I probably shouldn't do that. It's gonna kill him.
The attack is devastating.
Getting hit with a 9 will knock out any fighter with a single strike, no matter who it is.
Unless it's
when
a big stage.
When his back is against the wall,
or
Mr.
Super
Game
Armor.
& Watch might try his luck with a judge attack.
Leaving victory up to luck doesn't seem like the best strategy.
Well... Luck is part of every victory.
So you better watch yourself, Pit.
God damn it, 9! Where's the 9? That's not 9. Anytime now. Yeah, taking the 9 really is lucky. There we go! Dun 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 dun. Watch and listen. Sounds so much like Snake's theme, like... Oh, I wish Snake was back in this game. I really do, along with Shadow Moses, so that we can have a codex for new characters as well. Like, I wouldn't mind seeing a codex for, like, characters like Bowser Jr. or Palutena or something. And Lil Mac, that'll be pretty interesting. Or Pac-Man. The third-party characters talking about other third-party characters, that'd be even more cool. Whew. Duck Hunt sales. The game Duck Hunt holds 28 million. Okay. Who's Magus? Oh, whatever. Okay. Hope that didn't fuck up the thing. I seriously hope that didn't fuck up the thing. There we go.
This guy looks ready to fight.
Oh crap, oh crap!
As a boxer, fighting is sort of his thing. No one can match his strength on the ground. But in an aerial battle, he's helpless.
So you want to get him in the air and keep him from landing.
He has a power meter that, once full, lets him unleash a lethal attack.
He seems tiny, though.
Maybe that's why he's Little Mac. But even with his small stature, he's triumphed over many heavyweight boxers.
Oh my god, Pit's actually taller than him.
Puny human.
Bring it on. The stronger the opponent, the more interesting the fight.
That's the spirit.
I can keep using my weapons, right?
Yes.
That's unfair. This guy's using his fucking fist and you're using a goddamn sword and bows and arrows, and Pit, you're a dirty fighter. By the way, a fun fact about Little Mac, I found out he's actually 5'7". That is my size! So basically, I'm as tall as Little Mac, and by that definition, I'm shorter than Pit. Oh man, I feel so puny. As if my size wasn't fucking small already. Okay, after Little Mac, who's that? I think we go into the next round, right?
Survival.
Yes, we do. Link. The fairy boy with a sleeping cap on his head. Oops. Oh. Yes, you know what it is. I accidentally pressed start, and that activated the custom stage, and the first thing that had to pop up is that fucking thing. Alright, get over here. Speaking of get over here, GET OVER HERE! Alright, This is gonna take forever. I wanna know how long this is gonna take. La la, okay. What's the lyrics for the song anyways? Is it just gibberish?
Link is the one I most want to take down.
Oh?
Why's that?
Why's that?
You're born around the same time. We both use a bow. He's totally ripping off my style.
Please! Comparing Link to you is like comparing a star to a campfire.
What?
Just look at those chiseled features.
Oh my gosh, she's getting horny.
His cheekbones could seriously cut glass.
Earth to Viridi!
Viridi, that's her name.
Oh, I'm only kidding.
Where the fuck is Viridi?
The goddess of nature would never be interested in some hairless monkey.
Oh, humans aren't all that bad. I could introduce you to him, if you'd like.
If you insist.
Back to the fight at hand.
Too bad Link's already taken.
You can reflect Link's projectile attacks using your guardian orbitars.
Just
by two women,
for
by the way.
Claw shots.
You still have a boner for him. Just admit it. I will admit, Link is pretty sexy looking, though.
No contest.
One of the reasons why I broke up with my girlfriend. Just kidding. But, yeah. Link. Basically, every girl I talk to thinks Link is fucking hot, even though Link looks like a dude. Like, looks like a girl. Speaking of girls, Zelda, let's go, dudes. So yeah, I want to know why only this version works and not the Omega version of the stage.
Three, two, one, go!
Kind of weird trying to use two controls at the same time. What the fuck are you doing, Zelda? There we go. It would be really fucking awesome if the Hyrule Warriors costume for Zelda makes like an alternate costume for her. I really wish that would happen. Like, if they have Ocarina of Time Zelda with her blonde hair and such, Why not have Hyrule Warrior Zelda? Or Skyward Sword Zelda. Well, no. Skyward Sword Zelda would look really awkward. And would definitely not fit in. Like, Zelda right now looks very elegant and ready for battle with her shoulder pads and armor belt, I guess. She just looks more sophisticated in this one.
This isn't quite the Zelda you're used to.
I hear she no longer changes form in battle.
That's right, but she's got a new special move, the Phantom Slash.
Where does she get the Phantom from?
It's hard to say. Magic.
Wow, I didn't realize she was such a powerful magician.
I could do something similar, I'm sure, but it's pretty dark magic. Now, what part of you should I use to make your Phantom?
My Phantom? You don't have to do that for me, Lady Palutena.
Oh, don't be scared. I'll just equip you and...
What will it cost me?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe just your soul.
Look how pale he got! You're really scaring him. Listen, Pit. If you can knock Zelda's Phantom out, she won't be able to call it back for a bit. Keep an eye on her.
By the way, according to tier list, this move sucks major donkey balls, so never use it. Yeah, and I've actually played Zelda sometimes. I never use her Phantom Slash whatsoever. It's not really that good. Next up is Sheik, right? I think. Yeah. I want to know why Ganondorf is unlocked at the very beginning in this game compared to 3DS version. Like, in 3DS you had to unlock Ganondorf, here he's available at the beginning. It's kind of weird, like... He's pretty much always been like an unlockable character up until this game. Alright. Ninja dude, let's go!
I wish I knew Sheik's true identity.
It is one of the great mysteries of our time.
Really?
Are you guys for real? You can't be serious!
Compared to the other fighters, Sheik moves very quickly. Don't get overwhelmed by Sheik's speed, especially one-on-one.
Wait, that's it? Oh, come on! That was way too fast! Come on! I was kind of expecting something a little bit more longer, like more details on her combat style, or jokes, other than like that. Oh, come on, you don't know that they're fucking whatever. But, I mean, I guess it's kind of hard to make a script for every single character. I wouldn't know how to make a script for... I don't know. Ganondorf's next. The Great King of Gerudo Evil. The only male citizen in the Gerudo Valley. Is there any other male Gerudos? Like, if they were to reproduce, what would happen to the male, and why is he the only male available? Like, if there was a Ganondorf Jr., I don't know.
This Ganondorf guy definitely has the evil look down pat.
He can sometimes take another form. As Ganon, he's known as the King of Porkins.
God, he's tall.
It's actually the King of Darkness. He's brought Hyrule to the brink of ruin more times than I can count.
My arch-villain database doesn't bring up anything about his past.
Wow. I didn't know you had that app.
What?
A goddess must preserve some sense of mystery.
Wait, huh? So...
One
Greek
thing you
gods
know
use this iPhone?
There are many different
such?
Ganons.
Just like there are multiple Lynx and Zeldas.
But don't let that confuse you. I've spent years studying Ganon, can't I?
Remember,
what?
Ganondorf is as heavy as he is powerful. Use that to your advantage.
So, how's the CDI Ganon hold up then, Viridi? She'll be like, that game does not exist. Okay, good god, Ganondorf's tall. I kind of expect him to be a lot more taller because Ganondorf is supposed to be like 7 feet tall, correct? Yeah, the whole Ridley is too big debate, bullshit, Ganondorf. speaking of small characters. I still like his, entrance, as ever. I didn't see everyone's, entrance, actually. I haven't really paid attention. Pretty sure the Brawl characters are the same. Come on, Pit. There we go. Oh crap! Don't do that.
This guy's eyes are the size of my head.
He must be the famous Toon Link.
Where'd he get that name from anyway?
It's probably because he looks like he jumped right out of a cartoon.
Yeah, but so is Pit. Is.
What's the matter, Pit?
It's just not fair, Lady Palutena.
What?
One Link is handsome, and the other is adorable. They're cherry-picking the best bits!
Aw, is poor Pit feeling a little insecure today? Snap out of it, Pit!
I'm pretty sure there's Pit fangirls, right?
Here's the deal. Toon Link is quick, but lighter than regular Link. Don't get distracted by his weapons, or his intense cuteness. Just calm down and plan the best counterattack.
Okay. Pit seems to be very jealous of Link's popularity, I guess. I want to know what Link thinks of Pit. He probably doesn't give a shit. That's how much testosterone-filled substance. I don't know. This is going to get old. Next character, Samus, I think? Right? Oh, I really can't wait to... I seriously can't wait until they talk about Zero Suit Samus and her physique. Yeah, it seems like every character is relatively the same. Does Samus get faster or something? I can't tell. I know this game got faster, definitely.
Oh look! There's Metroid!
<That's Samus.
laughs> Just like Link isn't named Zelda. Isn't Icarus.
Okay, this joke is officially made forced.
Moving on now. Yeah, you can refer to his charge shot as orbitals. However, Samus can throw a storm shot.
I love this game. Oh my god, I really want to play Kid Icarus now.
As opposed to your usual game plan.
I really want to play Kid Icarus. Hey, look, it's Metroid. Oh, this has got to be the best one to this date. Like, so far of all the codex, this is definitely the best one. Oh man.
Survival.
Oh, like that guy's not named Animal Crossing. Oh, wrong character.
Zero Suit Samus.
Wait, what do you mean? You mean Star Fox is not his name? It's just Fox? I thought Fox was his last name. No, it's McCloud. Well, why don't they call it Star Fox McCloud? Alright, she's got a lot more agile! Hey, Pit, Samus took her clothes off.
Who's that woman?
Like that ass?
That's Zero Suit Samus. She usually wears heavy armor, but not in this incarnation. Even so, she's still pretty powerful.
She has some pretty hurdy-looking equipment. Getting kicked by those jet boots has gotta sting.
You have a good deal of hurdy-looking equipment yourself, Pit.
Yeah, and can you believe that there are some fighters that battle empty-handed? Crazy!
It's all about discipline, not weaponry. Don't worry, though. When we get home, I'll enroll you in Palutena Boot Camp. That'll fix you right up.
Or I can just keep my weapons. Yeah, let's do that.
Anyway, Zero Suit Samus is a difficult target to hit. Keep your attacks sure and steady.
Isn't Samus also born the same year as Pit and Zelda? Or sorry, it's Pit and Link. Hold on. Well, Zelda too, in a way. I know Ganondorf doesn't make an appearance until Ocarina of Time, right? Because the original villain was Ganon, and not Ganondorf. So, technically, Pit, Samus, and Link are all the same age, even though Pit looks young as fuck. Like, I could believe that Samus and Link are the same age, but Pit?
Three, two,
nuh-uh.
One.
All right. All right, so this is a codec with himself. My knee is like touching the trigger button on the PlayStation. Oh no, not PlayStation, the Classic Controller Pro. Did I just really call that thing a PlayStation controller? Is there a codec for myself? Yes, there is. Okay.
Wait a sec. Is that me?
It certainly appears to be the case.
You're awfully calm about this, Lady Palutena.
Well, we've been through a similar situation in the past, don't you recall?
Yeah,
no. But it's still freaky. It's like looking through a twisted mirror. That reminds
but
me.
But with clothes different.
You know how Dark Pit came from a mirror? And why doesn't he move left when I move right? And vice versa?
Beats me.
But you're supposed to know everything. Don't you have an all-seeing eye and an all-knowing brain and all that?
My all-seeing eye sees you getting hit.
Oh, man, really?
I'm sure the true Pit would triumph over any doppelganger. So I guess now we'll see if you're the real deal.
Oh!
Have you noticed that I can kind of fly on my own a bit?
Actually, it's called jumping, Pit. Sorry to be the one to break it to you.
So, basically, this kind of stab at God himself. You're supposed to be the all-seeing eye, right? Yeah, but I don't feel like seeing everything. Basically, Palutena is the equivalent of God trolling.
Survival, Palutena.
Why can't you feed the children of Africa? Eh, they need their lost weight anyways. I mean, we got already obese people in America. We don't want two more.
Three, two,
oh, that's so
one,
offensive, I'm sorry. Alright.
You shall be purified.
Why the fuck did I do that? Is there also a different codex if I taunt down with Palutena? I wanted to see just in case. I'll give it 20 seconds tops.
Wait a minute! Lady Palutena, you're fighting me?
Don't sound so dismayed. Think of it more as a sporting event and less as a massacre.
I really don't want to hurt you.
That's awfully presumptuous of you, Pit.
Please, I know better than anyone else what Lady Palutena is capable of. After all, I fought her once before.
Good luck, Pit. You're gonna need it. Of course, I won't be giving you any hints during this battle. And no powers or centurions either.
So...
Ready when you are.
I don't think Palutena has, the codec, right? I don't think so. Okay. And who's after this? I don't know, I don't really watch the character select screen that much, so... I don't remember everyone. I think Captain Falcon's next, I don't know. Marth, I'm way off. How is Marth gonna handle? It's only three characters so far. I was kinda expecting to see like someone like Hades or something. I don't know. Maybe Medusa. I mean, I guess those are the only heroes of this game of Kid Icarus. I don't know. I don't play Kid Icarus, so I don't know too much.
Get a load of Mr. Fancy Pants here.
Oh, you got a problem?
Jealousy I detect in your voice, Pits?
Why would I be jealous of Marth?
Well, he's a prince for starters. A handsome prince. And you're
Marth looks like a chick.
Anyway, Prince Marth's most dangerous attack comes from the tip of his sword. Avoid his blade when you're at mid-range.
So I should either attack him from a distance or get up close and personal.
He's got a counter as well, so be on guard when you go hand to hand. If you're attacking from afar, use items to improve your chances.
Yeah, what if you're playing no items, final destination only? How does that work? Answer. Throw the controller and go to. Play a real fighting game. All right. Fire Emblem characters. Next is Ike. Ike. He's off. I really want to know why Marth still has his Japanese voice, though. Like, is it really that hard to hire an English voice actor for Marth? I mean, I know they're using a lot of assets from Super Smash Bros. Bros. Along with the voice actors, like Mario's voice is the same, Luigi's voice is the same, Link's voice is the same. The only new characters that have the same voices, that have different voices, are like Pit, Ness, Kirby. That's pretty much it.
Does I look a little different to you? A little tougher?
Like more steroid filled?
His clothes look different, and his sword looks even more menacing.
Yes, I suppose you're right.
And he definitely hasn't aged well.
Well, compared to gods and angels like us, Ike is just a baby.
I don't know how old you are.
He's a pretty sexy-looking baby.
You don't look like you've grown at all.
Like you're one to talk. How old are you anyway? 10?
A goddess never reveals her age, Pit.
Break it up, you two. Back to Ike. He has a powerful side smash that will send you flying, but that's also his weakness.
He's very vulnerable at that time, so dodge it and strike back.
I claim this victory in the name of Sky World! Sky World! Sky World!
Yeah! Sky World! Sky World! Sky World! Sky World!
You two are babies, you know that? Like, how old are these two, ladies and gentlemen? Well, then again, if Viridi has the ability to feel crushes, I'm pretty sure she's at least, I don't know, 12. Well, then again, women usually develop puberty earlier than men, right?
Survival.
I don't know how science works.
Robin.
Teen Titans, go! Would there be a difference between male Robin and female Robin? I don't know. Also, what happens if I pick, like, Al for something? And Olimar. Would there be a difference? Or would they be the same?
Something weird about this fighter, Lady Palutena.
That's Robin, also known as the Avatar.
Avatar, the Last Airbender. Then everything changed when the Fire Nation attacked! What the fuck?!
Where did you come from?
No, seriously, what?!
Skilled strategist and master of both Eleven Sword and magic.
Yo, hey, Troy Baker, what's up?
A swordsman like myself.
Plus, you and Ike are too similar. No point in having two characters that are pretty much carbon copies, right?
Oh, explain Lucina, then.
What's more, you don't have an ether recovery move like Ike does, do you?
Quiet, you.
Back to the topic at hand. Robin can use the Eleven
Sword
and magic.
So what's Crom doing here?
Times. Use this limit to your advantage.
Why is he here, and why is he only in this?
This fight is in the bag!
I wouldn't be so sure. For Robin's final smash, I plan on lending a hand. And then you'll taste the bitterness of defeat.
We know you're trying to play the hero and all, but you can only join in if Robin gets the smash ball, right?
Oh wait, we disabled it. Oh no.
Right after Robin gets the smash ball.
Yeah, that looks... I don't remember Crom sounding like that in the 3DS version. I don't know, like, that sounds way too much like Troy Baker to me. Is it Troy Baker? I don't know, I play Fire Emblem Awakening, I don't remember too much about it. Hell, when I see that announcement trailer for Robin and Lucina, I didn't even know who the fuck Robin was. It's like, wait, is he from Awakening? Like, who the fuck is Robin? And I found out he was the created character, and I didn't know that because I did not create Rob. I created a character that looks like Morgan from Darkstalkers. Anyways, Duck Hunt! Duck Hunt! This is gonna be interesting. He hasn't gotten a new game in years.
3, 2, 1, go!
I'm really loving the music, by the way. Sniff, sniff, sniff. I like how the duck is there just... God, that dog's a troll.
I don't want to fight that cute dog.
That ain't cute. That's a troll.
The dog and the duck.
So if I win... Is duck on the menu for dinner?
What?
Let's take things one step at a time, Pit. These two may seem like a duo, but they're actually a trio. Together, they're known as Duck Hunt.
So where's the third team member?
Listen, just be careful. You could get shot out of nowhere.
A mysterious sharpshooter, eh? Well, that does make things more exciting.
All right. What about the gun guys from... I don't know, what are those games? What's that game from?
No contest.
The dog is standing up! one of the Duck Hunt dogs animation is, goddamn troll laughing or something.
Kirby!
Well, at least we have the opportunity to beat the living shit out of Duck Hunt, so. Kirby, the little marshmallow that basically eats everything and kills everything and devours. And the little guy that's also gonna kill Majin Buu in Death Battle. Go, Kirby! Come on, let you win! And if Death Battle comes out before I upload this video and Majin Buu wins, I'm gonna eat my hat off. Kirby, you better fucking win! I don't watch my Dragon Ball Z, by the way, so... Sorry! Okay.
It's always easy to pick Kirby out of a crowd.
Aww, he's so squishy and adorable.
And deadly.
True, but he's still a formidable foe.
He's got all kinds of moves, and he's top-notch at recovering. Does this guy have any weaknesses?
Just what you'd expect. His weight, or rather his lack of weight.
So it shouldn't be hard to send him flying, huh?
Right. The question is how to do that.
Oh, that part's easy. Just keep wailing on him. Then we'll see who's stronger. That little puffball or Kirby.
Alright. Wait, who's next? DDD or Meta Knight? Those two always confuse me.
No contest.
So yeah, Crom joins in. Is there gonna be any other characters like Slippy? I want to see if Slippy comes in like Fox's or Wolf's Kodak or something, or Wolf. Oh, that'll be a real salt kicker. Or Lucas as Ness. Holy shit, that's gonna be an extra salt. Then again, Lucas does not talk that much, does he?
Who's this, Lady Palutena?
That's King DDD.
So, what do I need to know about him?
He's a heavyweight, but has the ability to fly. And his hammer attack is no joke. But every fighter has a weakness. For example, when King DDD throws a spiky Gordo, you can hit it right back at him. If you can eliminate him by reflecting the Gordo, that will count as your KO.
What's a KO?
Good.
A knockout? It's okay, Pit, don't worry, King DDD's bottom tier. I think he's... Here's the thing, like, King DDD's apparently more better than Donkey Kong. But, I don't know. I feel like Donkey Kong should have been more topper than DDD. Meta Knight's next, the one who used to be top tier in the previous game. I want to know if they actually referenced that, that would be pretty sweet. I mean, if they, fucking reference like something like Metroid. No, that's Zelda. And then why not? And your name is not Icarus. All right.
I wonder what Meta Knight looks like under that mask.
A Kirby?
Apparently quite similar to Kirby.
If he took off his mask, could he inhale things too?
Maybe. And maybe he has Kirby's copy ability as well.
So if a maskless Meta Knight copied a masked Meta Knight...
Well, what? Then he'd just be back where he started.
Anyway, be careful of his quick blade and his spinning attacks. They don't have a lot of power, so use your shield until you see an opening.
Okay, nothing too spectacular there. Again, I think that... Oh, ow, my ears. I think that sometimes, Snake's codec to certain characters, they don't really make... I mean, they make much sense, it's just that I didn't really find them fun. Not all of them have to be funny. They have to just be informative as much, and they'll be fine. Yeah, who are the, multiple different costume characters? There's, Bowser Jr. along with, like, Wendy, Roy, and other characters, right? I'm gonna try them. I'm gonna try them out at the end if I remember. Alright, Foxy Boy.
Got any tips for fighting Fox?
Fox McCloud is the leader of the mercenary flight team, Star Fox. His trademark is incredible speed.
It's about time you showed up, Fox!
That was a terrible General Pepper pick.
You should be wary of his blaster, too.
Everybody, stay alert!
Kid, stop getting distracted!
You might think Fox's blaster doesn't hurt all that much and ignore it, but you'll soon find you've taken lots of damage.
Sorry, I'm back. Okay, I'll just reflect the shots with my Guardian Orbitars.
I figured you'd say that.
Huh? Is that not what I should do?
Like I said, he's quick on his feet, so there's no telling when he'll suddenly rush in and grab you. You've got to watch your back constantly when Fox is around.
Do a barrel roll!
God damn it, Pitt. You deserve that. Next time, don't get distracted. Fox has a new voice actor in this. That sucks balls. I heard he's apparently the voice actor for Star Fox 64. No wonder it went bad. But even so, like, 64 Star Fox sounded deep. I mean, not too deep, but deeper than what he was talking. I don't know, how does Falco talk?
Hands off my prey. Piece of cake.
Not bad, but at the same time, I kind of miss his Brooklyn accents. Alright. Alright, come on, Pit.
Do you know who this is, Pit?
Falco Lombardi? Ace pilot on the Star Fox team? Great jumper!
Also a major exactly. Dick!
Captain Falcon's already got the Falcon motif. Falco looks more like a pheasant to me.
Sounds delicious.
God damn it, Pitts!
Keep your voice down. If he hears you, he'll make you eat his boots.
Falco used to be the leader of a galactic gang, so you can expect him to be good in a fight.
I'm starting to freak out here. I mean, this guy is famous throughout the entire galaxy.
Watch out for long-range attacks, like his reflector shot and blaster.
You'll see he's quick on the draw.
Okay, next up is Wolf. Oh, wait. I don't know. What's the next character? We got through the Star Fox characters. We got into Kirby characters.
No
Pokemon, I'm guessing? Next one's gotta be Pikachu, right? I'd be shocked if I was actually correct.
Survival.
Oh my god, I'm correct.
Pikachu.
Alright. Tickle with a Pikachu. It's also deadly and causes electric shocks to your brain systems. That's okay, you're a normal type. You're not weak to that. Wait, but Pit is a flying type. Oh, you're fucking screwed, Pit. Oh, good luck trying to survive his electric shocks. Wrong. I was about to press the D-pad on the plastic controller, which is set to Pikachu. Oh, I missed that Pikachu. Why doesn't Pikachu like close his eyes when he does that? Or she. Is that Pikachu a he or she?
Aww, look at that cute little guy.
It's a Pokemon.
And not just any Pokemon.
Actually, that Pokemon is called a Pikachu. Pikachu evolves from Pichu, and when a Pikachu is fully evolved, it becomes a Raichu.
It's quite rare for a Pokemon to be more famous in its middle stage than its final evolution.
True, but Pikachu is a special
Jigglypuff.
I mean, it's the most famous of all the Pokemon.
Excuse me. Hello?
What is it, Pit?
I hate to interrupt your musings on Pokemon, but I could really use some Smash Brothers help right about now.
Oh, right. I forgot where we were. Okay, here's a tip. Dodge Pikachu's thunder and then counterattack.
You can also
and then he's gonna smash down
thunder back at itself. And nothing is more satisfying than that.
I was so hoping them to reference Pichu a little bit. Because Pichu did appear in Melee, so I kind of wanted them to reference that a little bit. But eh. You can't expect everything, can you? Who's the next Pokemon? Jigglypuff, right? Charizard? Whatever. Charizard, okay. You know, it would actually look pretty cool if they aligned them by generations. Like, Lucario should have been after Jigglypuff. I mean, that would make sense, right? Jigglypuff and then... I don't know. Maybe it's because like Lucario's more popular than Jigglypuff. I don't know. But then, what explains your Greninja then?
Two,
I don't
one,
know.
Go!
Would you believe it or not that I said when Greninja first appeared, I had no idea who the fuck he was. Like he was like, who the fuck is that Pokemon? I never heard of him like at all. Like I don't watch the Pokemon scene that much, so I don't know what's popular and what's not. Kind of reminds me of Ridley.
Those wings might be majestic to look at, but they don't help much in the flying or gliding department.
A little short in the flight department? That sounds like a familiar predicament.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, Pidge, denial doesn't look good on you. At least least Charizard can use its wings for attacking.
And I can use my wings to fly. When Lady Palutena grants me the power of flight, please.
You know, I've always wondered if the power of flight would work anywhere besides your wings. Like your hair, for instance.
It's not funny. I'd go bald.
But I digress. Charizard has another attack called Flare Blitz. It's powerful but dangerous, even to Charizard. Either way, dodge the attack and keep your distance while waiting for your chance to strike back.
Insert clever pun here. Talk about the next character that's gonna come up. Complain that Mewtwo was not in the game. Be glad that he's a DLC character. Don't be glad that he's taking forever to be developed and coming out on May. Gotta stop making these jokes because these are getting old. Shut the fuck up, Bassinger 313, and start the codec already. Alright, let's do this shit. Mewtwo, what are you doing? Get there we go. Now if only that thing would come out faster. Complained about how that thing's not coming faster!
What the heck is that?
There's Lucario. What
it's the
you?
Sexiest Pokemon.
I've never seen
Don't
a
you like it?
A light force like that. It's like a current of water or a whirlpool.
Oh, you mean Lucario's aura.
Aura?
Lucario can sense the life force, or aura, emanating from all living things. As Lucario takes more damage, its own aura grows stronger.
Ingenious! Lucario sounds like a perfect fit for the forces of nature.
We need to focus on the fight at hand.
You focus on the fight at hand. I gotta catch my new recruit.
No, stop!
For what?
Pit, a wounded Lucario is stronger than it looks. Be extra careful when it's taken lots of damage.
Okay, next up is the second marshmallow. I don't know why I keep calling Jigglypuff and Kirby's marshmallows. Like, I don't know. They look like marshmallows, right? They're like squishy little. I guess marshmallows are really soft and squishy. That's why I thought of Jigglypuff and Kirby because they look very soft and squishy, right? Don't you want to just hug and squish those little things and hopefully not kill them? Ugh. But then again, be careful of Jigglypuff's rest.
Three, two, one, go!
That's Jigglypuff, the balloon Pokemon.
Look at the way it floats! It must be light as air.
Don't let its cuddly appearance.
So they actually buff the rest
of the
time or the sleep.
Fighters out there.
Sing, fire.
And it has a deadly attack called Rest. When Jigglypuff lands this move, the effects can be devastating.
However, that move does render Jigglypuff vulnerable for a short period of time afterward.
So when you see Jigglypuff start to fall asleep, that's your cue to move in for the kill.
Gotcha. I'll be sure to keep an eye out for when it nods off.
Hold on a minute. Oh, come on, that doesn't kill him! Hold on. There we go. So much for looking out on the lookout, Pit.
Yeah.
I don't think there's gonna be anything that's gonna match up Samus's codec. I know they're definitely not called codex, but I might as well call them codex because that just remind me too much of that, right?
Three, two, one, go!
I remember Greninja having like a really weird voice. He was like, "Crack! Greninja! Greninja!" It's something like that.
Some kind of ninja frog?
That's the Pokemon Greninja. Its strengths are agility and speed. What looks like a scarf is actually its tongue.
As a defensive measure, I suggest rubbing spicy peppers all over yourself.
How can Greninja taste anything with its tongue hanging out like that?
It could be one of those rare ninjas that just eats very slowly.
What? But that makes no sense! Anyway, just tell me how to win.
Greninja creates throwing stars out of compressed water and unleashes them at high speed. This attack is called Water Shuriken. If Greninja starts to charge up its Water Shuriken, be prepared to reflect it back.
Okay. So, lame jokes aside. Yeah, so far, I don't know, like, clever jokes like the whole Metroid. I guess I'm liking the referential jokes rather than the literal jokes when it comes to, like, these types of things. I don't know, do I really need to play, like, Kid Icarus Uprising in order to really understand and like these jokes? Because, I mean, I'm not saying they're bad. Wait, his default is the American Rob? And not the Japanese? Oh, that's interesting. Is the Japanese version Rob's default is the Japanese Famicom one, or what?
Three,
okay.
Two, one, go!
Oh, fuck. Wrong D-pad. What the fuck's wrong with me? Wow. That was a huge fail.
Look at that cute little robot.
ROB isn't a very creative name for a robot.
I think it has
robotic
a certain ring to it.
Operating buddy.
No way! Any name's better than ROB. Like, how about Mr. HVC-012?
That doesn't exactly roll off the tongue.
How about RoboBuddy 3rd Edition?
And what happened What's to it? The first two editions?
Oh, good point. How about Zergbladron?
Let's just keep things simple by calling him Rob.
The light on its head shows you the strength of the laser it's about to fire. The moment you forget about it, it'll unleash its laser at maximum power, so watch out!
I actually did not know about that. That's actually a really good tip. Like, I didn't really know about, how to determine Rob's power, but now that they gave me that tip, that's actually pretty cool. The way Rob claps right now, just... How? Who claps like that? Like, you have to be like a... That sounds like fapping, doesn't it? Okay, Ness, what happened to Lucas? Why do you have PK Freeze? God damn it, I wish Lucas and fucking Wolf would turn as DLC characters, and Snake too! If that's possible. Please. Alright. Any time now, Pit. You just like Pit, any time now. You did not get hit, you're still at 0%, Pit. Bada bada bum bum. Bada bum 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 bum. There we go.
On some weird kind of energy here.
What you feel is Ness's PSI.
What's PSI?
It's a general term for supernatural abilities.
Supernatural? Isn't that pretty unscientific?
Said the angel to the goddess.
Exactly.
Pit, we're having this conversation via telepathy. Meanwhile, the power of flight is a type of psychokinesis, and I see you from the heavens using clairvoyance. Finally, I call you back from the battlefield with something akin to teleportation.
And believe me, I truly appreciate all that stuff you do with things.
Anyway, if Ness tries to recover via PK Thunder and you reflect it, that will really ruin his day. Give it a try when you get a chance.
Oh shit, that would actually... Oh man. What's the matchup for Pit against Ness in this game? I imagine like that reflecting thing would be a real dick with something like... And a Ness that gets another Ness, like PK Thunder, and then the other Ness would go over to that PK Thunder and do PSI Magnet, and then that's just gonna make his recovery fail. So, yeah, like, even though Ness could really recover a lot, it's not gonna help if he's gonna fall into oblivion. So wait, hold on. There's the male Weefit. Well, they have the same name, so it's most likely that they're gonna, like... Unless the Wii Fit Trainer is determined by she when they talk to her, then I don't know. But Captain Falcon.
Three, two, one, go!
Speaking of Assassin's Creed, why does this music remind me of Assassin's Creed?
Whoa! It's Captain Falcon!
Oh, he's a captain! What ship does he have?
I think he's more like a pilot or something.
All these fighters have tons of skill and experience, but you can still hold your own. If we brought vehicles into the picture, though, that would be a totally different story.
Good thing that's not the case. I'd be no match for an F-Zero machine or an R-Wing.
Plus, those G-diffuser systems are terrible for the environment.
Well, you sure know a lot about space machinery, for being the goddess of nature and all.
Anyway, if you're
I think you have to be...
Falcon, watch out for his jump and Falcon Punch combo.
What? You mean this? That's not a combo, that's just a Falcon Punch. That's it. That's not a combo, Palutena. What are you talking about? So yeah, if you're the goddess of nature, you have to know what the fuck's ruining your nature, right? Which is those electromagnetic bobble things, right? Is this... Are all Nintendo games canon or something? I don't know. I thought, like, Nintendo's story is all the Smash Bros. Story is all about, like, some kid playing with his toys or something. Well, then again, his toys of Sinister Sons are now insane. Let's assume, like, the N64 version is when he's, like, 6 years old, and now he's, like, hold on. It's 1999, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Let's just assume 15 years has passed and he's in his 21s, still in his mom's basement, and still playing Smash Bros. With his toys. Let's just assume that, alright? Like, the N64 version is like this kid, and Smash Bros. For Wii U is like him in his 20s or something, I don't know. Which is why there's a lot of people. Wait, but then Brawl would be like, hold on, 2008, 14 minus 8, that is 6, so that's 6 years ago, 20 minus 6,
oh look, it's the villager.
14, he'd still villager, be pretty puberty.
That's not a very creative name.
Well, what else do you call someone from a village? Anyway, you've got to respect the village.
Citizen?
No one fights
a resident?
Why is that?
I don't know.
Probably because where the villager's from, there's a mole who goes around punishing cheaters.
What?
Anyway, the villager's
mole rocket
can do some real damage, so try your best to reflect it back.
I forgot what I was up to say. Oh yeah, yeah, I'm gonna try out Olimar. Olimar's next, right? If Olimar's next, I'll try Alf first and then Olimar, so... Just to confirm if it's the same thing or the different characters. Because it makes no sense to... There we go. Alf! Who's Alf from again? Like, is he Pikmin 2 or Pikmin 3? I don't remember. I never played any of the Pikmin games, so I don't know shit about Pikmin. I just know that this is a really, really good strategy game, I believe, and it's all about time management and building up an army or something. I don't know, and the kind of like a sim, like one of those Sims games.
Oh, it's that explorer guy.
Did you know that Pikmin are named after Pik-Pik carrots, a vegetable native to Hokitate?
Huh. Guess you learn something new every day.
Enough with the pointless fun facts. Let's talk fighting strategy. Here's what I know about those Pikmin. Red Pikmin are strong. Yellow Pikmin fly high. Blue Pikmin have the mightiest throw. White Pikmin are fastest. Purple Pikmin are heavy and the most powerful. Be sure you remember all this, Pit.
Right.
I don't think I'm gonna remember that.
There are also winged Pikmin that don't attack you. Numerous Pikmin will weigh down the winged Pikmin, and that's when you should attack.
So it doesn't seem like they reference Alf, but at the same time they don't reference Olimar either. So, yeah, I'm gonna check Olimar just in case to see if he actually does have a codec though. So, how long have we been recording this game? I feel like we've been doing this forever or something. There we go. So yeah, they talk about Pikmin, but they don't talk about Olimar or Alf or anything, and I just dropped my controller for now. I'll do the same thing for the Koopa Link just in case. Oh, wrong way, wrong controller. Alright, does Olimar have something different or is it the exact same thing?
forgot.
Did you know that?
So yeah, it is the exact same thing. So I'm assuming the Koopalings are going to be the same thing as well. Well, then again, they referenced Bowser Jr. by name, so didn't they? They were talking about how they got, like, Bowser got him, like, a Clown Jr. card thing, so it made no sense if they talked to, like, Wendy or Roy or something like that. If I'm speaking of Roy. Roy's our boy! Roy's... I remember there's, like, this Facebook post, and they were talking about the characters. One of the statuses for Roy was Roy's our boy, and it was just... Oh, that is just trollish, Nintendo. Alright, so... Yeah, because they mentioned Bowser Jr. by name. It makes no sense for not reference Roy by name either. Or any of the Koopalings, really. If they each had their own separate codec, that would be fucking... exhausting. Like, I can imagine having separate codecs for Bowser Jr. than having it for the Koopalings, but every single one of them, that would be hectic.
That's one of the Koopalings. Roy Koopa.
Oh my god, they...
The resemblance to Bowser Jr. is strong.
I think they actually
have... The Koopa clown car is the mass-produced type.
I guess as heir to the throne, Bowser Jr. would get preferential treatment.
The relationship between Bowser and the Koopalings is a real mystery.
I kind of feel bad for them.
That's sweet of you, but not very conducive to taking them down, Pit.
Okay, so they reference Roy's name, but it seems like the second half could be referred to any other Koopaling. Like, they don't go into the specific as to what Roy, who Roy is. Like, Roy looks like a really brute force server character. I don't know. Like, if they just replace Roy with Wendy or whatever, then... That's understandable. Let's try Ludwig. Like, if they're gonna make any magician jokes, then I'd be all for it. Ludwig sounds weird. Alright. So if it's gonna be the same thing, then I'm probably gonna skip all the Koopalings.
That's one of the Koopalings. Ludwig von Koopa.
So yeah, it's the same thing, basically. next up... God, I lost track. What's after Pikmin?
No contest.
What is after Pikmin? Weefit Trainer?
Survival!
Wii Fit Trainer. Okay.
Knight,
fuck no. How many characters do we have? We got some left. I wonder if there's gonna be a different resemblance between the brawler me, the sword me, and whatever.
Three, two, one, go!
Wii Fit Trainer is pretty fast for physique. I mean, again, she is fit, so it makes sense if she's fast, but... I don't know, she seems like Mario speed or something.
Who's this now?
She's also fighting barefoot.
She's an exercise coach.
She.
I hope you're in shape, Pit.
Well, I walk everywhere, so I'm probably fine.
Oh, of course! You're always at the beck and call of the Goddess of Light.
Well, angels are messengers of the gods.
That's where you're mistaken, Pete. Angels are nothing more than divine interns.
In any case, be careful of her sun salutation move. It gets stronger with deep breathing.
So, they said she. So I'm assuming they would say he if... I don't want to confirm that. It seems like it's an answer. They'll say he if it was a male fit trainer. It would be funny if they say she instead, though. Because... You know, male Wii Fit Trainer.
Survival.
Shulk. I could imagine a possible cameo for Shulk's character. I don't know much about Xenoblade Chronicles though, because like... Considering how I've only played like the first 2 hours of it, I don't know much about Xenoblade Chronicles. I just know Shulk is the main character who wields Monado. And he has the power to see the future.
That's Shulk. He's 18 years old and clocks in at 5 feet 6 inches.
So he's smaller than Little Mac? What? That's bullshit. No, he's not.
Makes us look like a bunch of jokers.
The Monado can change Shulk's strengths and weaknesses. For example, it might increase his jumping ability while decreasing his defense.
So for every strength he gains, he also gains a weakness.
Yes, and Shulk can KO opponents easier when they've sustained more damage. But if you know his weakness, he's not too difficult to deal with.
Let's not lose our heads, though.
What's with the fucking British accent, Pitt? Trying to make fun of them? Pitt's racist. Hello, chaps! Fancy meeting you here, ladies and gents. Wait, that's Australian, not British. Never mind. God, who's the racist one now? Fuck you, Pitt. Alright, Shulk, now it's up to clone characters. Oh boy. So yeah, Lucina, you have no excuse. If... God damn, like, with... God... With that insult to Crom, like... What the fuck does Lucina have? Alright, Dr. Mario. Let's
go. I don't think that's a real doctor.
I wouldn't be so sure. He delivers crushing blows, so he must be very knowledgeable about anatomy.
But not the regular Mario.
I hear he treats viruses by randomly throwing medication at them.
I'm so glad Skyworld doesn't have checkups.
Dr. Mario is slower than the regular Mario, but he's also more powerful. Don't get sent to the emergency room. You don't know what kind of treatment you'll get.
Okay. So next up is Dark Pit. Ooh. I want to know why Dark Pit has not been,
No contest.
I want to know if Dark Pit has the codec, like... I don't know, like... Who's the main Hades? So if I press down on Dark Pits, then will Hades show up or something? Oh god, that's gotta be in another separate video or something, right? Hell first appeared in 2013.
Three, okay. Two, one, go!
How appropriate that Dark Pits theme is playing right now. And I just dropped my controller, damn it. Alright, here we go.
Hey, it's Batuu! Will you quit calling me that?
Hi.
Wow, he's... After the fight with Hades?
He sounds way darker. I mean, more deeper.
He's an officer in the forces of nature.
What?
No way!
What?
Just because we fought together once doesn't mean we're all buddy-buddy now. In fact, the Lightning Chariot and Phosphora are also both under my command. The battle isn't over yet.
Verita's interests and mine just happen to overlap. So for this fight, I'll be happy to launch you into the stratosphere.
Your powers are perfectly matched here.
It all comes down to skill.
Okay, so...
Game on! Game on!
I don't think Dark Pit has a codec, does he?
Game on! Game on!
The fight is on! Oh, I didn't say the fight is on. Okay, so I'm guessing Dark Pit does not have that. Okay then, so it's only Pit. I mean, I guess it would be a lot of exhausting work to have every single character, I guess, so... Eh. You can get what you have, I guess. Bum 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 bum. So Lucina, a clone of Mars. Not feeling so sure about that comment to Crom now, right? Doesn't Ike also have like a costume of Crom? Much like how... Marth has like a costume of Roy. The only thing they're missing is like the red hair.
I cannot lose.
That lady's moves are awfully similar to Marth's.
That's Lucina. She used to introduce herself as Marth, so certain similarities seem inevitable.
What? She stole someone else's identity?
Well, it wasn't quite like that.
Marth had become a legend by her time, the Hero King. So Lucina took that name to bolster the morale of her own army. Think of it as a symbol of hope in the depths of despair.
That's pretty deep.
You can't tell by looking at her, but I hear she's got a great sense of humor.
Does she? What?
A few jokes and see if that softens her up.
The tip of her blade doesn't deal as much damage as Marth's, but her attacks are more balanced, even if they are not tremendously powerful.
Okay. So what the game is basically saying is Lucina is weaker than Marth? What? What are you talking about?
No contest.
Okay, so we're done with the clone characters. Now it's time for the third party characters. It'll be interesting.
Pac-Man.
what are our Kid Icarus opinions on the third party characters, and what'd be like if Snake was in this game? Oh, this song sounds really pumped up. All of these gotta be references to something, right?
Walk him.
Yes, that's Pac-Man. He was born in 1980, which means he's 1 year older than Mario.
Oh, another industry veteran.
His most famous form is shaped like a pizza missing one slice.
He has wrong controller, damn it!
But the main thing is to avoid him taking a bite out of me.
Yes, especially with those wings of yours.
What do you mean?
I bet they taste great with a little barbecue sauce.
Okay. Palutena, you're kind of... That's kind of cold, Palutena. Like, are you... Do you want to eat Pit's wings? I mean, I'm pretty sure they taste delicious and taste like chicken or something, but... That's just... You're eating Angel's wings. That's... Ew. Would that be counted as cannibalism or something? I don't know. Mega Man, the Super Fighting Robot! Super Fighting Robot reference, please.
Hey, look! It's Mega Man!
Is that really him?
Wait, what about a Captain N reference? That'll be pretty sweet.
I hope he busts out his Mega Buster.
Whoa! Keep it PG, guys!
Shield! Rush Coil!
Metal Blaze!
Spark Shot!
Air Shooter!
Crash Bomber!
Flash Claw!
Flame Sword!
Hard Knuckle!
God, you guys are nerds, you know that. Didn't Pit and Mega Man meet each other in Captain N or something? Like, Pit shouldn't be fanboying too much to Mega Man because they met each other before. I don't know.
No contest.
Oh my god, that gave me the idea to put Simon Belmont in Smash. That would just complete the trio of Captain N characters. Oh fuck, wrong controller. Two more characters to go. Possibly four, who knows. Hi, Sonic! Hey, look, it's that guy from that shitty video game, Sonic Boom. He looks different without the scarf. He looks less Uncharted-like. Oh. And... Come on, Pit. So what's with the Pit 2 last name thing? Like... What's with that nickname? I'm probably gonna have to understand and play the game myself in order to understand what's going on with the Pulpit 2 thing.
For being a hedgehog, Sonic really isn't very spiky, is he?
Yeah, I've seen spikier. It's true that you're more likely to find him curled up in a cute, harmless ball.
Not so harmless. That round shape lets him spin dash with ease.
I've changed my mind. He's entirely too spiky.
Spin dashes are hard to stop.
Just keep your cool and don't lose focus. You can stop spin attacks using your Orbitars or bow.
I kinda expected Sonic to move a little bit more faster. Am I asking too much? Alright. I should make like a test stage to see who's the fastest character compared to other characters or something. Alright. Okay.
Survival.
Last character of the day, Joel from The Last of Us. Let's do this. I wonder why he's participating in the Smash Bros. Fight.
Three, two, one, go!
I just noticed the main characters are all capitalized, but the meat characters are lowercased. Fuck me. Come on. Okay, Pit, come on. Is there a codec for these Mii fighters? That's my... Okay, there we go.
That gear looks like it belongs to Mega Man.
Or maybe Samus.
Oh, so it's different.
Wrong. That's a Mii gunner. All of them carry arm cannons and backpacks.
That backpack looks heavy, but that's because it's filled with different types of ammunition.
So there's possibly different...
Choose which type of ammo to shoot.
There's a motion-controlled trigger in the arm cannon.
So the stance they take when firing tells me where they're aiming.
Motion control. That's downright revolutionary!
No one's gonna give a shit about motion controls later on, though. Wow. That's obviously a stab at the Wii, isn't it? How motion controls, like, technically they revolutionized everything, but at the same time, like, it's only because every single person's mom was buying that or something, which grants a shit ton of units. And even though people don't like to admit it, the Wii technically did win last generation. Noriko from Heavenly Sword? Was that the game's name? I don't know. Who am I missing? We got the Gunner, we got the Swordfire, we're missing the Brawler, so...
One, go!
Alright. So there is different codecs for different Mii fighters.
What do we have here?
That's a Mii Swordfighter pit. As a general rule of thumb, you should take armed opponents seriously. Which really isn't easy in this case. That Mii is awfully funny looking.
No arguments there.
But Miis are full of special needs, so it's essential to figure out what they're capable of quickly. They often have some unexpected techniques, too. If you get careless, you may find yourself in big trouble.
Okay. Now one more character to boot and we can finally end this damn video.
No contest.
And that is Mii Fighter.
Survival. Mii.
Okay. A Bowser imposter, a loss of the fake loot, but
two, one,
okay.
Go!
About this fighter.
Here we have a Mii brawler.
This fight's gonna be really easy if my opponent's unarmed.
Listen to Mr. Tough Guy here. That's pretty presumptuous to think that this fight's already in the bag.
Oh, like you're one to talk about looking down on others.
But Viridi's right. You can't underestimate this foe. The Mii brawler is far from being unarmed. Those fists are weapons in and of themselves. They pack a real punch, so you should watch out for even straightforward moves like the side smash.
Okay, okay. No talking trash about any of my opponents. At least not until after the fight.
Alright. So that's all the codex for the Palutena's Guidance. Thank you guys so much for seeing my reaction. If you guys enjoyed that, then I don't know, leave a like or something. I don't know, it's your choice. You don't have to if you don't want to. But it's much appreciated. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the future. My Let's Plays is Bassinger signing out.
Survival.